In this presentation, we will discuss how you can choose a motor driver chip for your automotive body electronics application. Texas Instruments offers motor driver chips to fit just about every automotive application. TI offers motor drivers with one-half bridge for a single motor running in only one direction, and multi-channel motor drivers with up to 12 half bridges in a single chip for multiple bidirectional motors. We also offer motor drivers with integrated MOSFETs, as well as gate drivers for use with external MOSFETs, giving almost unlimited range in terms of motor current. We will briefly discuss some of the selection criteria, such as how many motors or channels are needed, how much current is needed to drive the motor, the size of the motor driver circuit on a printed circuit board, and thermal constraints. Various types and sizes of electric motors are found throughout an automobile. DC brushed motors are commonly used in many automotive body applications due to their simplicity and cost effectiveness. While every application is different, we can give some general guidance on selecting the right integrated circuit to best match the requirements. This partial list of typical body motor applications shows the wide variation in requirements. Most applications require the motor to drive in two directions, but a few, such as cabin blower fans or windshield wipers, only need motor rotation in one direction. The operation time, which affects thermal calculations, can range from very short durations, such as door locks, to continuous operation for hours. The normal and maximum current levels can also vary widely, and that can have a strong influence on the selection of motor driver IC. First, let's look at motor current as one way of deciding which motor driver IC to choose. This table summarizes some of the popular automotive drivers for brushed DC motors. The top blue rows are gate driver devices, which use external MOSFETs but otherwise integrate all the features needed to drive high current motors. The maximum current they can drive is limited only by the characteristics of the external FETs. The middle red rows are motor drivers with integrated MOSFETs with a wide range of maximum current capability. These are offered as either single half bridges or full bridge, two half bridge devices. The bottom pink row is a family of multiple half bridge drivers with integrated FETs. These devices are well suited for applications where several channels of relatively low current are needed. Another way to look at TI's brushed DC motor drivers is by the number of channels as well as the current levels. For low current applications needing several half bridges, the DRV8904Q1 through DRV8912-Q1 are a good fit. For single and dual half bridges with medium current, the DRV81XX and DRV82XXQ1 devices should be the first choice. For high current applications, gate driver devices with external FETs should be used. Here, various applications are plotted with the current versus time curves for some of the motor drivers. Lock motors typically operate for a second or less and might have maximum currents up to 10 amps. The DRV8245Q1 might be a good fit. A power headrest could be adjusted for a few seconds with a current of about 5 amps. A DRV8243Q1 would be a candidate. The mirror fold motor, you could use an DRV8244Q1 or DRV8245Q1 to drive up to 10 amps for a few seconds. Pop-out door handles with a maximum current of about 8 amps could select the DRV8244Q1. Low current motors for the ventilation dampers and side mirror adjustments could use a DRV89XXQ1. With up to 12 half bridges in one package. Window lift motors can have currents well above 10 amps, so a gate driver with external FETs is a good choice. There may be several seat motors with high current in each seat, so a multi-channel gate driver like the DRV8714Q1 or DRV8718Q1 is a good choice. So far, all of these applications have been bidirectional, but some motors only need to turn in one direction. Windshield wiper motors are typically unidirectional and rely on mechanical arrangement to turn the rotary motion into wiper motion. Due to their high current and long duration operation, a gate driver with external frets is probably needed. Similarly, the cabin ventilation blower runs in one direction and can run continuously. Depending on the current, a DRV8144Q1 might be a candidate. Some blowers use brushless motors rather than brushed motors. For these, look at TI's BLDC motor drivers. In many applications, board size is a significant constraint. Let's look at how the different choices compare in terms of area on the printed circuit board. The DRV8718Q1 and external FETs provide 8 channels of high current half bridge drives. This view shows the relative sizes of the gate driver chip and 8 dual FET packages. This arrangement can drive up to 4 independent bidirectional motors or up to 7 motors with some constraints on simultaneous operation. The DRV8714Q1 and external FETs provide 4 channels of high current half bridge drives. This can drive 2 independent motors or up to 4 single direction motors. The DRV8706Q1 with external FETs provides 2 channels of high current half bridge drives. This can drive 1 bidirectional high current motor or 2 unidirectional motors. The DRV8245Q1 includes integrated drive FETs to control a bidirectional motor with a maximum current of 32 amps. The DRV8244Q1 can drive a bidirectional motor with a maximum of 21 amps. And the DRV8243Q1 can drive a bidirectional motor with maximum of 12 amps. The DRV89XXQ1 family of devices has 4, 6, 8, 10, or 12 half bridges to drive multiple motors and loads with currents up to 1 amp on each half bridge output. If we consider just the package sizes, we can compare the area for either the gate driver with external FETs or integrated FET motor drivers. In the case where 4 half bridges are needed, 2 of the DRV8245Q1 devices in either the HTSSOP or hot rod package are significantly smaller than using a gate driver solution. The gate driver with external FETs can be designed for very high currents, but if the current specification of the integrated FET devices are sufficient, these have a clear size advantage. In this example, the DRV8714Q1 gate driver is shown along with 4 dual FET packages, plus 2 3-watt current sense resistors, and all the passive components to implement a 4 high current half bridge design. This could be used to drive 2 independent window lift motors or 3 high current seat motors with some constraint on their simultaneous motion. Here we see 2 DRV8245-Q1 devices next to each other with the associated passive components included. This also implements a 4 half bridge design, but for typically lower currents than the gate driver design. For applications where the current matches the specification for these devices, a very compact solution is achieved. For low current motors such as mirror XY adjustment and ventilation dampers, the multi-channel DRV8904Q1 provides an even more compact design. For loads currents up to 1 amp per output, as many as 12 half bridges are available in this same package size. When driving motor loads, thermal considerations can also be of high importance. Thermal issues are related to package size and current levels, with additional constraints and trade-offs. In general, high current applications using gate drivers such as the DRV8706Q1 or DRV8718Q1 don't have thermal issue with a gate driver device itself. This is because the high motor current flows through the external FETs rather than the gate driver. The external MOSFETs used with TI's gate drivers are available with a wide range of on resistance in a variety of packages. Many automotive FETs are rated for operation with junction temperatures up to 175 degrees centigrade. In a high current application, this can be an advantage in terms of thermal performance. The packages typically have large metal heat slugs to aid in transferring heat away from the transistor and into the printed circuit board. This leads to a relatively low thermal resistance from junction to ampient, known as theta JA. The innovative packaging of the DRV8243, 44, and 45Q1 devices give them even lower theta JA values than the external FETs, which is a significant advantage in terms of power dissipation in a small package. The parameter of thermal resistance from integrated circuit junction to ambient temperature, that is theta JA, can be used to compare the thermal efficiencies of various devices. The dual MOSFETs in a 5x6mm package have a thermal resistance of 85 degrees per watt, while the single MOSFETs in a similar package have a lower thermal resistance due to the larger continuous thermal slug. The DRV8245Q1 in a small 3.6 by 5.6mm package has lower thermal resistance due to the hot rod flip chip packaging technology. The DRV8245Q1 in the HTSSOP package is somewhat larger but has an even lower thermal resistance than the VQFN hot rod package. The thermal constraints of integrated circuits are based on internal power level and duration. TI motor drivers typically are specified for operation up to 150 degrees centigrade at the integrated circuit junction and have thermal protection features in case that junction temperature is exceeded due to application fault conditions. External factors such as board design and ambient temperature also affect thermal calculations. In general, high currents are possible for short duration, and longer durations with lower currents are also fine. On the product page for the DRV8245Q1 and other devices in this family, you can find a thermal calculator that estimates the internal junction temperature based on several factors, including the current profile and type and size of printed circuit board. You can use this calculator to see which of the devices is the best fit for your specific application. Let's wrap up with a review of what we've discussed. In summary, designers can select from a broad range of motor driver solutions to meet the needs of just about any application. While we have discussed some of the main criteria for choosing between the various devices available from Texas Instruments, there are other reasons why one device or another may be the best fit. For example, the method and precision of current measurement for system feedback or type of interface between the motor driver and microcontroller may be a key consideration in some designs. Other features such as diagnostic and protection against fault conditions, built-in braking, adjustable voltage slew rate during pulse width modulation, or availability of a charge pump voltage might be valuable in specific applications. Overall, motor drivers from Texas Instruments fit the needs of designers for all types of automotive designs.